Hi everyone, welcome back to Spring Boot Essentials. So let's see how we can get the information from the logged in user and how we can, for example, just add a login page from Spring. So if you are looking for getting the information from the user that's logged in, you can go into the controller and, for example, we could use here find by ID, and you just add one annotation called authentication principle, and here you just use user details. So I will type here log.info user details, and I will add a breakpoint. Okay, now I will start my application. So we just have to send something else here in the test. Okay, so my application started. I will go into Postman, get all enemies. I don't have any, I will add one. Okay, I'm still with the user logged in. Just go into the get by ID, click on send, and now you can see that we have the user details, and we have username, we have the authorities for that user, role user, and then we have a couple more attributes that they are coming from the user details class. So if I log in with a different user, for example, William and Password Academy, I click on send, you will see now that the user is William and I have two authorities. Okay, let's say that now we would like to add the login page. So let's come back to the security config. And if you are a bit confused by this, the DSL on IntelliJ, you can disable the formatter, but you have to activate these in the preferences. So now if you try to organize the code, it will just avoid this block. So here we are saying to disable CSRF, and then we are telling to authorize any request, and I would like this request to be authenticated. So we can even do like this, and now we have here this end. And this end, HTTP basic, we can add something in between. And for example, I would like to have like a form login. You could have a custom page, but I would like to have a form login, and this form login will have HTTP basic authentication. So when I do this and I restart my application, when I go to my browser, you can access localhost 8080/login, and now we have this login page that we can log in, for example, William and user, sorry, William is the user and Academy is the password, and we get this 404 because it tried to redirect me to the index page. We don't have any index page or endpoint, but if I get my enemies, you can see that we have all of them, and if I try to get one, I still have my user details, that is William. Now it generates a login and a logout page, so we can type here /logout, and you see that we are logged out. And if I try to access /enemies, it's redirecting me to the login, and when I log in, it will send me to /enemies. So this is happening because we have some security filters. So basically, Spring Security is just, well, in an overly simplified way, a bunch of security filters. For example, we have a basic authentication filter. So this filter, it will try to find the basic authentication header on the request. And if it finds, it will try to authenticate the user with headers, username, and password. The second one, it's a username, password, authentication filter. So what this one is doing is trying to find the username and password on the request of the post body. And if it found, it tries to authenticate with those values. The other one is default login page generating filter. So basically, this filter will generate a login page for you. And if you don't explicitly disable this filter is why we get this login page that we just saw here. And if we have login, we also have default logout page generating filter. This one is the logout that will kill your session. And we have another one, the last one. We have way more, but these are the most common ones. Filter security interceptor. Basically, this filter security interceptor is the one that will do your authorization. So remember, we have two steps. One is authentication, and another one is authorization. So if you have problems remembering authorization, if you have any problems remembering what these are, just imagine that you are entering an office building. Usually when you get in, you have to stop by the reception and you have to tell who you are. So when you tell who you are doing the authentication. And they will probably give you a badge, and this badge will have some specific access, let's say to a couple floors. That is authorization. This means that with that badge that you got when you got authenticated, you only have access to a few resources. Basically, that badge, it's what we have here. It's your roles. So based on these roles, it will give you access to a specific floor or doors that we can configure by the pre-authorize, for example. So this is it for the Spring Security authentication filters. These are the basic ones, and this is the process of authentication and authorization. So I see you in the next video. Bye.